Wow, this room is huge. Look at all those seats. Is there really going to be 273 people in here to watch the show? Oh, I could just tell, I guess, how many seats there are. This would be a fun room to fill up. Much more roomy than under your bed. Or your whole bedroom, for that matter. Oh, don't worry. I've got it under control. Confining myself to this body instead of being an infinite tentacle pit doesn't exactly come naturally to me, but it's not too bad. I'm used to thinking of two or three things at a time. Like, right now I'm thinking about how nice you are and how much I like this dress you bought me. And how much I'm looking forward to snuggling with you tonight. Thank you for taking me here. I don't think I've ever had this much fun. Do you think the Science Museum will have another adult night? I wish I could have spent more time in the acoustic room, and I hope they finish installing the dimensional rift. The dimensional rift? That big glowing thing next to the magnet exhibit? You can't see that? Oh. Well, don't worry about that then. How do you know where to sit? Is it better to sit in a row all by ourselves? That's... what a human insight. Those armrests do fold up. If we're gonna lay on the seats like they're a couch, can I lay my head in your lap? It's my favorite, but... if we need to wait until we're home, I understand. Yay! Oh, your lap is so comfy. I don't like pillows. Pillows aren't alive. Pillows don't care. You're alive. You care. That's why I like resting my head on you. Feeling your heartbeat. I like it when you pet me. Stroke my hair. Your affection makes me sleepy in the best way. Like I could curl around you and be still. That's all I would need. It's very tempting. When your finger brushes my ear or my cheek, I just want to let a little tentacle out and grab your hand, hold you to me, but I don't want you to stop either. Is that strange, that I want all the head pats, but I also want you buried in my grasp?
Our show will be starting in a few moments. Please find your seats. Remember that there is no video photography. And please, be courteous to other guests by not speaking.
Oh, can we still whisper? Good. I have something to tell you. You are a cutie. Did I do that right? I'm trying to explain this feeling where I want to mush you, but with my heart, you know?
The night sky.
Oh.
Our daytime star is bright and beautiful, but when it is hidden by the earth beneath our feet, other bodies become visible. There are around 5,000 stars visible with the naked eye.
That's weird. There's only 51 in this representation.
But due to the glow of our atmosphere, caused by terrestrial lights bouncing off the gases around our planet, you may only be able to see a dozen of the brightest stars on any given night. Let's see what our view would be on a perfectly clear night.
Oh!
The likes of which we haven't enjoyed since the Industrial Revolution.
Oh my gosh. That's astounding. Look, look. Oh, this is so neat. Everything looks how it's supposed to. Even the hum is lined up. Most of the time I can only feel the stars. Oh, it's really nice to see them clearly too.
Tonight's visible planets are Venus, Mars, and Jupiter. While usually Venus is the closest planet to the Earth, tonight Mars is the closest, and shall be for the next few weeks.
Oh, this is so neat. You were right, I love it. Does this mean I have to think of a perfect date for you? I don't know how being on Earth would top this. Maybe I'll hop into that dimensional rift and take you out of the system? I could engulf you, and you'd be weightless. Or maybe we could go for ice cream instead? I'll think of something.
For tonight's constellation tour, we will be skipping ahead a few hours. Hold on tight while we fast forward 6 hours and observe how the stars move. We are time traveling at a rate of 10 minutes per second.
Oh no. Oh no, no, no. No, this is wrong. No, go back, go back. Please go back. This is all wrong. Where am I? When am I? Wait, where are you? Oh no. I'm gonna lose it. I don't wanna... Oh, gotta see the real sky. I see you. You have 2 eyes, 10 fingers. You're holding me because you're here with me. I'm scared. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. Oh, you got me. You're gonna make it okay.
We have arrived. And just in time, too. In a few moments, we will get to observe a shooting star from the northwest. Make a wish.
I'm gonna keep my eyes closed. Can you please keep stroking my head? It helps a lot.
Our first constellation is Virgo, named after the Greek goddess of justice. Virgo warned Zeus and the other gods that there would be no peace when the golden age of old ones, the Titans, ended. When she was not heeded, she flew into the sky, separate from gods, separate from man.
Oh, I know it's not real. I'm sorry. Do you promise you're not mad at me? Of course I have to apologize. You shouldn't have to deal with me or my problems. That's so sweet. You always know what to say. You promise I didn't ruin everything?
The immortal Hydra is the largest constellation. Originally a Babylonian monster. Part serpent, part lion, part eagle. It is most known today as the dread beast only the hero Hercules could slay, a symbol of infinity. For each head severed, it grew 2 more.
No, 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 I don't want to go. I'm comfy here. I can just listen. And if listening is too much, I'll just listen to your heart.
The Hubble telescope has produced a special image of the Hydra, or, more accurately, part of the Hydra. We've augmented tonight's sky with this high-detail vision. Can you tell the difference?